Big weather story looks like this for today. Warm conditions, still very comfortable though, but turning hot as we go into the weekend. Our temperatures possibly going back to the lower 90s into Saturday and Sunday. I like to remind folks that hydrant parties in full swing in Council Bluffs. Now you're thinking to yourself, what about Omaha? What's going on? They don't start until Monday of next week. So hydrant party today across the river. 33rd and 4th, lower to mid-80s, and June 11th is actually the start date for the hydrant parties in Omaha. 65 Norfolk, 67 degrees in Fremont, with temperatures at 64 in Atlantic, 63 also a common number in Harlan. It is currently 66 officially at Epley Airfield with a southeast wind at 6 miles per hour. We've been talking about these showers and thunderstorms trying to move down towards the south, and yes, we could see a small chance for a shower or a storm maybe around Carroll or Atlantic, with much better chance for more widespread rain, where organized showers and thunderstorm activity is going to be just east of our coverage area and eventually stretching over towards areas like Ames and Des Moines too, and even areas south of there later today. Showers and storms coming to an end as of right now across the panhandle. These aren't severe. These storms will ignite once again late this afternoon into the evening hours. If you're traveling that direction later today, watch out for thunderstorms from North Platte westward. This line later this afternoon will try to shift east, but fall apart, that is, across central portions of Nebraska. And you lock yourself into portions of eastern Utah, Colorado, New Mexico, and Arizona. Fire issues still taking place there because the weather conditions are just favorable for what would continue to fuel wildfires, and that is the big problem nationally when it comes down to severe weather in a whole different form. This is the picture with our storm predictor. We advance towards about 10 a.m. Some showers, some storms, mainly east and northeast of the Omaha Metro, and we advance towards about the 5 o'clock hour tonight. There's a small chance for a few showers, maybe east of our area, up across northwestern Iowa. More storms developing westward across western South Dakota into the panhandle of Nebraska, northeast Colorado. We could see some severe storms in that particular area. Otherwise, 80s. O'Neill, Hastings, 80s over towards Des Moines, Kirksville too, with temperatures in the mid-80s out towards Denver. Watch what happens tonight as these thunderstorms move eastward. This is 10 o'clock right here, excuse me, and that is basically where the thunderstorms are going to die out, come to an end. Watch what happens. They fizzle, fall apart. This is 7 a.m. tomorrow morning. Maybe a shower or two west and northwest of us, and there's some indication that some storms could try to develop, let's say from Minneapolis to Sioux City and back towards Grand Island by 5 p.m. tomorrow, but not likely affecting our coverage area. 73 at 10 a.m., mild, partly cloudy skies. Temperatures around 82 at 1 o'clock with the south wind at 10 miles per hour. By your 4 o'clock hour, 86, partly cloudy. I'm thinking about 87 for a daytime high today. And then 79 by 9 p.m. with a south wind at 10 miles per hour. Your 7-day forecast is in the upper 80s to lower 90s to start the weekend. 90s hold strong Sunday. Our next best chance for rainfall and thunderstorm activity is Sunday night into the first part of Monday.